Hello, friends. My name is Barbara. I'm here. Important decision in your life. I want you to listen to me. Listen to me very carefully right now. The words I'm about to speak to you are the words of life. The most important thing I want to tell you is that I personally met Jesus Christ. I'm here to witness to you about Jesus Christ. And I'm going to ask you the most important question. What do you think will happen to you when you die? Because most of people in this world say at someone's graveyard, rest in peace. They think an angel is looking down on them, that the person is somehow interceding for them, helping them. But that's not the truth. The truth is that if you don't reconcile with God, if you don't reconcile with God in your lifetime, you will be forever separated from the goodness and the love of God. You will die separated from God. I'm not here to tell you about any religion. This country is filled with religion. I'm here to tell you that meeting Jesus Christ has nothing to do with religion. Meeting Jesus Christ is about your personal encounter with God, with the goodness of God, with the love of God, with the solution that God has for your life. You may think you deserve to go to heaven because you are a good person. You may think you deserve to go to heaven because you are a really religious person. You may think that you are a nun or a priest, or because you've done some rituals in your church that classifies you to go to heaven. But I'm here to tell you that unless you reconcile with God, unless you personally say to Jesus that you want Him, unless you open your heart, unless you call on God that you want Him, you will not reconcile with God. Jesus Christ died for your sins, for the sins of humanity. Died for your sins 2,000 years ago. But it's your personal decision if you want to receive that God. It's your personal decision if you want to bend your knee and bow down and say, God, I need you. Jesus, I need you. I want to reconcile with you. I want you to be my master, my savior, my Lord. It's only then you get to meet the true God, because the gospel is so simple. It's so simple. The gospel says that if you recognize your own need for God, if you recognize that you cannot do it on your own, if you recognize that you need the grace and the power of God into your life, you will be saved. 10 years ago, someone told me the gospel. Someone told me about Jesus. And it was a very strange information for me, because I was brought up a Catholic. I went through all the sacraments. Jesus to me was just a part of a big row of religion. He was just one small part of the whole religion. He was just standing next to many aspects of religion. I never understood how important Jesus was. But I had depression. And I was an unhappy person. I was living in a beautiful country. I finished a really great degree at university. But I couldn't understand the meaning of life. I didn't understand. I had a sense of sadness, a sense of loneliness, a sense of longing, a sense of emptiness. And one day I cried out to God. I cried out and I said, God, they told me about Jesus. And I don't know you. I don't know who you are. I don't know if you are Buddha, if you are Muhammad, if you are Mary, if you're the Pope, if you are Jesus. I don't know. So show me. I need you. If you exist, I need you. And something extraordinary happened. Something amazing happened. Something cannot be described. I met Jesus Christ. He came to me. I met with love. I met with the goodness of God. I met with the beauty of God. He made me a new person. He didn't repair me. He didn't make me a better person. He didn't make me a more religious person. He gave me a new mind and a new heart. I understood that Jesus is the only way. He is the only salvation. I understood that there is no one else but Jesus. I understood that religion has nothing to offer but a delusion. It's a delusion. It's a very dangerous delusion that tells you that a form is more important than the person of God, that your form and your own doings, your own rituals are more important than a personal meeting with God, heart to heart, eye to eye. Because only such a meeting, yes. Так, порушальник, пальцы не может порушить. Only the person of Jesus Christ has the power to change your life. Only the person of Jesus Christ has the power to rescue you from the meaningless and the vicious circle of your own life, of chasing after illusion, gallery of illusions. Chasing after illusions. Illusions that your career will save you. Illusions that money will save you. Illusions that your husband or your wife is the solution to your life. Illusions that if you're a good person, something is gonna balance itself out, that this is gonna be enough to go to heaven, that's gonna be enough to save you. None of those things can save you, because the power to save you is only with the person of Jesus Christ. He's got the power to save you, and he's already done everything needed for your salvation. And the only thing that's needed, it's your decision. So I call on you now. If you're hearing me, I'm asking you now to direct your heart to God, to Jesus. Call on him. Call on him and say, Jesus, I want you. If she is telling the truth, I want you. I need you. Come into my life. Come into my life. I want to meet you. I want to meet with the truth of who you are. I don't want to live separated from you anymore. I don't want to live in illusions. Jesus, come to my life. Fill me with the power of the Holy Ghost. And give me a new life. Become my friend. Become my Savior, become my Lord. Call on the name of the Lord, and he will save you. Amen.